Dear viewers of the Tom Photo channel, if you have a Fujifilm camera, you have certainly noticed the dynamic range settings of 100%, 200%, and 400% in the menu. How they work and what they do is our today's topic. You may want to watch my video on Fuji's highlight and shadow tone settings linked below, because this is very much related to dynamic range. And I talk about tone curves there too. Higher dynamic range means a wider tonal range in the photo. It means more details in the shadows and highlights. Your photo will contain more information. It might also look better. The dynamic range is primarily affected by the size, architecture, and characteristics of the camera sensor, but also by processing algorithms, ISO, lens, lighting, and more. So how exactly do the dynamic range settings work? I will sometimes refer to dynamic range simply as DR. So at DR 100%, you get the normal exposure that is a balance between shadows and highlights. When you increase it to 200%, then the exposure time is shortened by one half to make sure that you capture more of the highlights. This makes the shadows too dark, and this needs to be fixed. It is fixed by lifting the darker tones in the tone curve. At DR 400%, the exposure time is shortened even more by another one half. Again, adjustment of the tone curve will follow. The adjustment of the tone curve will unfortunately introduce some noise, so higher dynamic range levels may increase noise. You can combine the dynamic range settings with the tone curve settings, as I talk about in my video link below, and this will allow you to control the tone curve of your JPEG even better. What happens when you increase the dynamic range value is that you also increase the base ISO value, and this introduces noise as well. Some Fujifilm cameras, such as the X-T10, have an EXR CMOS sensor, and they can partially get around this problem at the expense of image resolution. I'll talk about this in another video quite soon. The dynamic range settings are there for your JPEG, not for the RAW file. So working with RAW files is generally a preferred method to improve the dynamic range because you have more options and can get better results. Still, the preset dynamic range settings are a good option when you need to get results on the go. Okay, it's time to do some experiments now and photograph something with pretty high contrast at three different dynamic range settings. Let me do this at different ISO values too. I'm using my Fujifilm X-T30 today for the experiments. This photo was shot at exposure compensation of plus 1/3. I think it looks quite nice at DR 100% actually. This is comparing DR 100% and DR 200%. I think the main difference you'll see is that the snow has gotten a bit darker. When going to DR 400%, the snow is even darker. You'll also notice that the flower has a little less contrast. Here, the use of DR 400% was not warranted in my opinion. These two houses and snow photos were also shot at exposure compensation of plus 1/3. I'm only showing the DR 100% and DR 400% photos. The DR 200% would sit right in between. The snow is quite a bit more detailed at DR 400%. Do you see it too? I'm actually not convinced that the change is relevant and better in this situation. I had taken the previous photos at ISO 640. Let's jump to a high value of 3200 to see how the shadows behave when shadows are lifted at DR 400% relative to DR 100%. It seems to me that the shadows might be a little darker for the DR 400% photos, but I'm not seeing differences in noise. The two photos seem to have about the same amount of grain. So I cannot seem to confirm the belief that when you use DR 400%, you will ruin your shadows because of the lifting of the tone curve. But hold on, maybe the grain at ISO 3200 was already so visible at DR 100% that at DR 400% we don't catch the difference. Maybe the noise at ISO 3200 is not in the form of fine grain, but in a slightly different form, such as a loss of detail. Let's go back to ISO 640 and take a closer look too. We are at ISO 640 because this is the lowest ISO you can use with DR 400%. It seems that my suspicions were founded. I'm now seeing a little sharper grain at DR 400%. It looks like fine sandpaper. It's really not perfect at all at DR 100% either. Looks a little bit muddy to me. But remember that we are at 100% resolution here. I thought maybe it would be interesting to see how the relative sharpness varies when we increase the dynamic range setting. Check my link below to see how I do this. And this is most interesting. Here I have the two series that I shot. I used the same f-stop throughout each series. The values were standardized within each series to make the DR100% sharpness value equal to 1. At ISO 640, the photo is detected as more sharp at increased DR values. But at ISO 3200, the already existing grain is being played around in the shadows to form mud, and the overall noise is not affected much at higher DR settings as the sharpness measuring method sees it. In fact, the graininess is going down, if anything. So seemingly the noise is not increased, while in fact what's happening is a loss of detail. I should revisit this noise topic in my future videos. Let me add the values I measured for some other photos, including one at ISO 1600. And you see that the ISO 3200 was indeed an exception. The ISO 1600 behaves more like the lower ISO values did. So these numbers tell us that higher DR settings at the same base ISO value will affect noise in the photo. But let's now look at the situation with incredible contrast differences at ISO 640. Again, we are looking at DR100% and DR400% side by side. This time it is very clear that a higher DR setting helped a lot with the snow. It is very difficult to see, but the grain looks higher at DR400% when we zoom in to the max. The DR400 photo looks a bit like a fine sandpaper. Here is the same comparison as before, but now at ISO 3200. To me, the DR400% does not look any worse than the DR100%. Again, it seems like at high ISO values, the higher DR settings cannot ruin the photo much further. Luckily, we can again measure the sharpness numerically, and this is what I see. The results exactly confirm what we observed before. At normal ISO values, the higher dynamic range settings affect the noise measurably, but at high ISO values, this is not so because the situation is already quite bad, and the additional noise comes in not as grain, but as mud, if you will, or as a general loss of detail. Now the big question. Is the DR correction worth it in difficult conditions such as this, or would using a RAW file be a better option? I worked up the corresponding RAW file in RAW therapy. Please see my link down below to see how I do it. This is what I could do. The result is, of course, not optimal because the conditions were very difficult, but I think you agree that the RAW version result is better. What about the noise when looking at the photos at maximal resolution? My RAW file result looks better here too. This is because I used various noise reduction methods and advanced sharpening. Please see my links below. So I'd recommend using RAW files in difficult conditions. They take time to work with, but it is generally worth the time invested. In summary, if you want to use JPEG in high contrast situations, the dynamic range settings are a good option. They can reduce the quality of your photo at the pixel level, but in most situations, it won't matter. Just use the lowest ISO setting you can in those situations. My typical everyday DR setting is 200%. Thank you so much for watching. I typically ask you to consider subscribing to my channel and leaving a like, and today is no exception. I hope to see you again soon. Goodbye.